Good morning, everybody. How are we this morning? Good. Good to see you all. A few notices for you to browse over, as you'll see in your leaflet. First of all, we'll talk about pizza night. Pizza night is going to be on Friday the 12th of November at 7 p.m. So, as it says here, if you haven't received the invitation and would like to come, please see either Ian or Carol. There'll also be a Thanksgiving service for the life of Sylvia Fern on Saturday the 13th of November, 2 o'clock in St Mary's. So any of you that knew Sylvia would like to attend, you're most welcome. The film night, 19th of November, 7 p.m. Be showing Harriet based on the inspirational life of an American freedom fighter. So if that's what you'd like to see, you're most welcome also. Now then, the Parish Advent Quiet Day. At the 8 o'clock service this morning, there was a lady came to me and said that Reverend Celia, running the Advent Quiet Day, has had a telephone call from a member of the congregation, a lady, and it was a sort of garbled message. So if the lady is present here now, if you could contact Reverend Celia again and convey your message, she'll be most welcome to hear it. There is a sign-up sheet also for the parish Advent Quiet Day at the back of the church by the notice board. So again, if you'd like to attend that, please sign up. The Christmas fair, donations of books and CDs are requested. They're also after toiletries, bottles, raffles, anything that you think is appropriate for that sort of thing. And again, if you'd like to see Denise about that, then she'd be most welcome to hear you. We're also having the Christmas fair, the Jambola stall, looking for filled jars for the Jambola store, any jar, any contents. I'm not sure if that's absolutely accurate, but you get my drift. There's a green box in the tea room for you to put your jars in, and I think the challenge for these is if you can put a Christmassy type wrap around them or something like that, they'll be more attractive even then. Okay, so that's all I'm going to say for now. So quiet time just before we settle down for the service. Thank you.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. Good morning, everybody, and welcome. Lovely to see you. Lovely to see our services gradually filling up week by week, and we hope that by the end of the year, or certainly by next year, that all our friends will be back again. But lovely to have you today. Today is the third Sunday before Advent, and the opening hymn spoke of that prophetic vision of the future, when all wrongs will be righted, when good and righteousness will be vindicated, and when the kingdom of God will come upon the earth in its fullness expression, and Jesus Christ will reign. We come into the kingdom season now in these next few weeks as we prepare for Advent. But the Lord is here this morning, and he wants to meet us by the power of his Spirit. And so we pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus said, "Before you offer your gift, go and be reconciled. As brothers and sisters in God's family, we come together to ask our Father for forgiveness." Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Amen. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Stand for the glory.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. The Collect for the third Sunday before Advent. Almighty Father, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of all, govern the hearts and minds of those in authority, and bring the families of the nations, divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin, to be subject to his just and gentle rule, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our first reading is from the book of Jonah, chapter 3. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Get up,
Go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you. So Jonah set out and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk, and he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And all the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and everyone, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God changed his mind about the calamity that he said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The second reading is from the book of Hebrews, chapter 9. Christ did not enter a sanctuary made by human hands, a mere copy of the true one, but he entered into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God on our behalf. Nor was it to offer himself again and again, as the high priest enters the holy place, year after year with blood that is not his own. For then he would have had to suffer again and again since the foundation of the world. But as it is, he has appeared once for all at the end of the age to remove sin by the sacrifice of himself. And just as it is appointed for mortals to die once, and after that the judgment, so Christ, having been offered once to bear the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to deal with sin, but to save those who are eagerly waiting for him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We stand for the next hymn.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And as he went a little further, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending their nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Skirt is getting longer. Loving Father, take our minds and think through them. Take our lips and speak through them. Take our hearts and set them on fire with love for you. Amen. Please sit. I was thinking about some words from an American physician and poet, Wendell Holmes, Sr. And these are the words. "Some people are so heavenly minded, they are no earthly good." And I thought, that is talking about the merits of heaven and the merits of earth, as it were. And I thought, but you know what? One shouldn't be separated from the other. When we think of heaven, godly things, but he is in the midst of the earthly things, in the lowly and the mundane. And so often we think that God doesn't know what's going on earth, and we must just concentrate on being pious. And I thought of my little grandson. He was little then, he's now 18, but he was doing street dance. And he loved to go to his little groups, his little cliques. I can't remember the special name of his group, but they were all from all parts of the county at one Sunday meeting at a venue where there were loads of children. There were children, and of course, as a grandma, I went to see him. I didn't come to church that Sunday. I went to see my grandson. And he, amongst all these children, there were loads of them, happy, preparing, doing their thing, enjoying it. And I thought, yes, Lord, here these children are doing their thing. They have learnt to concentrate on doing their routines. And it's lovely to think that you're in the midst of all of that. But within my heart, I so longed that the children enjoying all that, which was good, should know that there was more. I wanted them to know that there is more. And I remember saying to one little girl who was going to do her dancing, and I didn't see her at church very regularly, and she said, "Oh, I'm always dancing on a Sunday." I said, "But you know, did you know that Jesus is the Lord of the dance as well?" Anyway, that's just in passing, really, but it has particular resonance in all that is about the kingdom. I know that I'm no great theologian, nor an academic. I wasn't very good at school, really, except for sport. But I know this, that God is real. The Lord God is one God, and I know him through Jesus Christ. I feel his presence by the Holy Spirit, the presence of the Holy Spirit. And there's a lot I don't know about the mystery of God, and can't pretend to unravel all that is the written word. In fact, only recently Ian preached a wonderful sermon about not knowing all. But so, like all of us, thirsty, searching, souls crying out with the psalmist, as a deer pants for flowing streams, so my soul longs after you. But I believe that God has made it possible by his Spirit to wake us up, our souls to be sensitive and alive to God, an internal spiritual pathway opened to respond to the healing love, the light that can never be put out, of Jesus Christ. Always thankful for the forgiveness and saving life of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. God in man made manifest, as the old hymn says. Jesus, human yet divine. He wants the light to get in through the cracks and crannies of our uncertainties. And so we need God's wisdom. That's the first thing we need to realize, that the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Not being frightened of God, but acknowledge his wonder and to realize that we need his wisdom. From heaven you came, helpless babe, entered our world, your glory veiled, not to be served, but to serve and give your life that we might live. Those words, the first verse of the Graham Hendrick hymn. The servant king, expected for centuries by the people of Israel, the hope, a Messiah, a comforter, the prophetic promise come through. As it says in Isaiah, the promise in Isaiah 52, heralded by John the Baptist, how beautiful are the feet of the one bringing good news. The kingdom of God in the person of Jesus, baptized by John, he identifies himself with sinful humanity. Acclaimed by God the Father, pleased with him, his beloved Son, led by the Spirit into the wilderness, faces Satan's worldly temptations to idolize possessions, power, and pride. His response? Love the Lord your God and worship only him. Jesus came, proclaiming the good news of God. The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news. Not just sorry for sin and wrongdoing. Yes, that. But his meaning is to turn fully around to God. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. And secondly, and to love your neighbor as yourself. The kingdom ministry, God's love, and the call for human response to God and to each other in every need. Jesus calling people to be disciples, ordinary folk like you and me into community. The invitation into the reality of God's kingdom now. God's kingdom, linking earth with God's holy presence on earth, as in heaven. In the prayer he taught, "Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven." And Jesus asks us for the love we need to have and to share, trusting, forgiving, self-giving love, wishing the best for each other. And I often think when we exchange the peace, we are not just looking to find our best mate and say, "My peace with you." We are saying, "The Lord's peace, whatever you need for the best that you can be from God is what I'm wishing you. Whoever you are, I don't know you, God does. And I'm saying that the peace of the Lord be with you." I think that is at the heart of love. And Jesus pointed to the sign through the reluctant Jonah. To be told and told again of God's mercy and forgiveness in action for the people of Nineveh. In his healing power, it was always to be seen as God's work. And he said after one of the miracles, when he cast out the demon and he was being blamed to have it by Beelzebub, in Luke, he said, "If I, by the finger of God, cast out demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you." And it was to open up, in all the healings that Jesus was doing, open up a deeper sense of God's vision. We needed more sight, not just the physical sight. We needed to jump up and walk, not just to walk in an ordinary way, but to walk in following Christ. Our ears to be open, all the wax, the unspiritual wax dug out, so that we might hear what God is really saying. So it is that in the cleansing, the healing, sight to see, the dumb to speak, the deaf to hear, is that deeper cleansing, that deeper healing of God's kingdom purposes. And it is God's realm, the kingdom. That is what it is. God's realm, the future reality as a total sphere of activity, and the new life of the crucified, risen Christ active in us now. But when in Luke 17 we read, he was asked, "When will this kingdom come?" Well, when will it come? The kingdom, when will it come? And Jesus answered, "Not with things that can be observed. Not look here it is or there it is. For in fact, the kingdom of God is among you." Mystery? Yes. But what is God saying to us? That he is crying out to us to wake up. The life and reality of the kingdom to be growing in us. Is it being denied or stifled? We ask ourselves. So as the people of God today, called to follow faithfully, Jesus continues to show us how to serve. God's way, the wideness of his mercy and love. The good shepherd who goes out to rescue the lost or wandering sheep. The father with arms wide open, looking out to meet and greet the wayward son as he comes back. In our lives, ordinary every day, with its joys and sorrows, successes and failures, We need each other. And together, challenge and break down the distorted social barriers to combat cruelty, hatred, and abuse, to gently and humbly serve. In a sense, there are two spheres of climate change to be addressed. One for the earthly realm and one for the spiritual realm. And it's to be one kingdom under God. And we pray for its coming, for the Spirit to work in us, and all to the glory of God and the peace, hope, and joy of his eternal kingdom. But we obviously need help day by day. When he says in the first, in the Beatitudes, when he says, blessed are those who are, how does it go? Is here, blessed are those who are really crying out and who know their need of God. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. When we know our need of God, we are already sensing that sense of God's kingdom. I believe God weeps with us, but he also wants us to laugh with him at times. A bit of relief among the struggles. Jesus offering light in the darkness. When I started wrestling with the text for today, well, you know what it's all about, and we need to wrestle. And I think what it's like standing up in front of your beautiful, bright, hopeful faces. Something came to me, an email, would you believe it? An email came in, and here it is. What it said is this: allow us to activate your souls, S-O-L-E-S. 20% off shop now. Well, you can imagine my amazement. Advertising shoes. And my imagination changed S-O-L-E-S to S-O-U-L-S. So it became from souls to souls, as I thought of what God wants to do. And I thought, yes. But then my imagination changed again. It wasn't just souls, but also souls. And you can see, hope you can see where I'm coming from. I immediately saw the connection. We remember the heaven and earth active together. We need both to walk with the soles of our feet shod and our souls immersed in God's work and meaning and purpose. And so if you remember what I said at the beginning, some people are so heavenly minded, they are no earthly good. There's the connection between that wonderful advertisement for shoes. Well, the Holy Spirit remembered. And he translated it. And this is how I understood it. He said, allow us, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, to wake up your souls for action with shoes on your feet. Whatever makes you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. And then you can walk in God's company, following Christ. In your company I'll go, where your love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow in you and you in me. Amen.
We stand as we confess the faith of the Church in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
At a time of turmoil in the world, when important decisions are being made, Father, we pray that you will be there and that your voice will be heard above the egos and self-interests. We pray for a time when common sense rules and we all learn once again to be good stewards of your wonderful creation. Show us the ways we can make small changes to help our wonderful world. We continue to pray for the discussions and decisions at COP26. We pray for all humankind and especially for those suffering poverty, persecution, oppression, and the effects of conflict. We ask you to give compassion, wisdom and courage to your children throughout the world, that they and we may defend those who suffer and work to bring relief wherever they can. Holy God, we thank you for the joy of human love and for all those among whom we live and work. We pray particularly for loved ones who worry us with their health or circumstances, or life direction. We pray now for all those whom we know and love and need our healing. Father, we ask that you ease the many burdens caused by day-to-day life and mend the brokenness caused by sin. Be with those who suffer and make your people whole. We especially pray for the church ministry here at St. Mary's and all the things that they're doing in your name. We ask that you guide them and help them so that they use their gift to proclaim your goodness to those who long to hear. We pray for those who have lost a family member, for families who are missing a loved one, especially at this time of year as we approach Christmas. We pray for those among our friends and families who do not know you or whose faith has been shaken. We pray too for Christians across the world. Continue to guide their faith and their journey. Lord Jesus, you said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be known as the children of God." And with this in mind, let us focus on the world leaders and ask that you help them to strive for peace, not only internationally, but also within their own countries. May peace begin with us in our homes, with our families and friends, as we strive to follow Jesus' footsteps. you also said, blessed are the gentle, for they shall inherit the earth. Help us not to be ruthless with one another and to eliminate the discord and violence that exist in the world around us. You again said, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Let us not be impatient under our own burdens and unconcerned about the burdens of others. You said, blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. Grant that we may be quick to forgive and slow to condemn. Lord Jesus, you said, blessed are the clean of heart, for they shall see God. Free us from our senses and our evil desires, and help us to fix our eyes on you. Faithful God, as we depart this surface after hearing the gospel and sharing in the Eucharist, may we, like your disciples, know the fire that burns in our heart, touched by the risen Christ in our midst. We ask that you gather these concerns and all who are in need of your abundant care. O God, remembering your promise of mercy, through Christ our Lord. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of our Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Would you please stand for the peace? Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Let us share with one another a sign of peace, being aware that COVID is still among us.
Peace be with you.
Peace be.
Sing the offertory hymn, The King
is
not my shepherd. Put this.
let us present our offerings to the Lord. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we give you. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ you shared our life that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word,
and I shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. O God of peace, whose Son Jesus Christ proclaimed the kingdom and restored the broken to wholeness of life, look with compassion upon the anguish of the world, and by your healing power, make whole both people and nations through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. We sing the final hymn. Will you come and follow me? God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.